Good morning, students. Now let's continue our chapter number 3, linear regression. This is part 8 video. Now we are going to continue our chapter with illustration number 18, which is in your page number 144 of your textbook. Now I request each and every student to just open your textbook and take out a pen or a pencil and a rough book and do the sums along with me. Now, the question says, the fitted regression line of y on x is y cap is equals to 50 plus 3.5x. If an observation 16 and 108, that is given in like this, okay, 16 and 108, that is x and y given to you, is used in fitting of the line, find the error in estimating y for x is equals to 16. So if your x is equals to 16, they have asked to find out the error. Then there is second question also given. If one observation 10 and 30, that is again given like this, x and y form, is used in fitting for the line y cap is equals to 22 plus 0.8x, find the error in estimating y for x is equals to 10. When your x is equals to 10, the y is asked. What can you deduce from the value of the error? So now let's do the sum on the board. Now you can see first question, that is y cap is given to you. So y cap is equals to 50 plus 3.5x given to you, right? Then what it is saying that find the error in estimating y for x is equals to 16. So when your x is equals to 16, then you have to find your y. Clear? So let's put the value of x is equals to 16. So y cap is equals to 50 plus 3.5. On the place of x, you have to keep the value 16. Clear? Then you have to multiply. Take out your calci. 3.5 multiplied by 16 is 56. So 50 plus 56 is equals to, therefore y cap is equals to 106. Clear? Now your x is equals to 16. So corresponding y is equals to 108 is given to you. Clear? You can see like this, something is given to you, 16 and 108. Now you have to find out the error. So error formula is, error is equals to y minus your y cap. So y is 108 minus your y cap is 106. Clear? So you can see 108 minus 106 is 2, right? So your e is, therefore your e is 2. So the error in estimating y for 16, for x is equals to 16 is 2. Clear with this? You can write it in a statement form. So the error in estimating y for x is equals to 16 is 2. Like this you have to do. Clear with this? So this is the completion of your first. Now you have to do the solve the second, that is the subsection of illustration number 18. So let's do this. Now the subsection, that is the second question. So you can see the question says, if one observation 10 and 30, that is given like this, that is your x and y given to you, okay, in this form, is used in fitting of the line y cap is given to you as 22 plus what it is 0.8x given to you, right? Find the error in estimating y for x is equals to 10. Then it is asking, what can you deduce from the value of the error? So your x value is given to you is equals to 10. So just keep the value of x as 10. So y cap is equals to 22 plus 0.8 10. Okay. So multiplying 0.8 into 10 is 8 plus 22. Therefore y cap is equals to 30, right? Now what you have to find out the error. So again, error formula is equals to, what is the formula? E is equals to y minus y cap. So your y is 30. Clear? And y cap is also 30. This y is from here. Okay, this data has been given to you. So from this you have to find out the y minus the y cap that you already found out is equals to, just deduct it. So your e is equals to 0. Clear with this? So the error in estimating y for x is equals to 10 is 0. You can write the statement like this. So the error in estimating y for x is equals to 10 is 0. Clear with this? Now since value of the error is 0, we can say that the point 10 and 30 lies on the fitted line y cap is equals to 22 plus 0.8x. Clear with this? Illustration number 18, both the sums we have solved right now. Now let's move on to the next sum, that is illustration number 19, page number 145. I am reading out the question. If the regression line of y on x is y cap given to you, y cap is equals to 25 plus 3x. Clear? And covariance xy is given to you as 48. Find the standard deviation of x. Also find the coefficient of determination if the standard deviation of y is 15 given to you. And there is other question also. So now let's read out till here only. Y is 15, that much only. So we will be calculating only first sum. Then after completion of the first sum, we will be moving to the next. That is the subsection of illustration number 19, the second question. Now you can see the given data is y cap is equals to 25 plus 3x and covariance xy is given to you 48. Now you have to calculate the standard deviation of x. Clear? In the first question it has been said like that. Now you can see y cap, the formula is y cap is equals to a plus bx. Clear? Now y cap, the numbers given to you is like this. So you can see from this only we can find out the value of b is equals to 3. Clear? Now we are also knowing the formula to find out b is equals to covariance xy upon s square x. So from this we can find, we are having the value of covariance xy, that is 48. Then we have to find out the s square x. So from this we can find out the s square x. So how we would be finding out b is equals to 3. Clear? Just look at this. I am putting the values is equals to covariance is 48 divided by s square x. Clear? So just you can keep this over here and 3 over here. So s square x is equals to 48 divided by 3. So 48 divided by 3 is s square x is equals to 16. Now this is variance. So if you want to find out the standard deviation, so square root of 16 is 4. So sx, that is standard deviation of x, is 4. Clear? So we just only wanted to find out this much only, that is the standard deviation of x is equals to 4. Now what they are asking, also find the coefficient of determination if the standard deviation of y is 15. So let's do that now. Now look, we found out the standard deviation of x, that is 4. Now they are asking if the standard deviation of y is 15, find out the coefficient determination. Okay, so the formula for coefficient determination is capital R square is equals to, you are having the formula, covariance xy divided by sx into sy, the whole square. Okay, so you are having the data with you. Covariance is 48, sx is 4 into 15, the whole square. Clear? So just multiply, 15 into 4 is 60. So 48 upon 60 whole square. 48 divided by 60 is 0.8. The whole square would be is equals to 0.64. So your capital R square is equals to 0.64. Clear with this? So you are having your y cap is equals to 25 plus 3x given to you, and you found out your b as number 3. Now what it is saying, see in the question, read the question again. For the regression line given in the above questions, okay, we are having the regression line. How many units should be increased in the value of x to increase approximately 15 units in y? Clear? So you can write it like this. Suppose x and y, if I have to increase one unit of x, I have to increase 3 units of y. Clear? So units of y. Now if I want to increase my, what it is said in the question, approximately 15 units in y, so 15 units I have to increase, so how much the x would be? So just 15 multiplied by 1, cross multiply and then divide it, divide by 3, so 15 divided by 3 is 5, right? So 3 units, sorry, 5 units you are having of x. Clear? 15 divided by 3. From where you got the 3? B is equals to 3. That is why. Clear? For 1 unit, 3 units. So, for you 15 units of y, how much for x? So, just cross multiply and divide. The answer would be like this. 5 units of x should be increased. Clear with this? Now, let's move on to the illustration number 20. Now the question says, if the regression line of y cap given to you like this, x by 2 plus 5, clear, and then sy is to sx is equals to 5 is to 8 given to you, find the coefficient of determination, that is you have to find your capital R square. Clear with this? So now let's do this. These are one kind of short sums that may come in your exam. So try to score more marks in such short sums. Clear? So see, y cap is equals to what it is, x by 2 plus 5. Now you are knowing the formula for y cap, that is y cap is equals to, the equation is like this, a plus bx. Clear? So you can see the x is over here, so you can just expand it. If I write 1 by 2 into x plus 5 is also x by 2 plus 5, clear, that is this one, this sum, okay. So if I write in according to this, that is a plus bx, that is your y cap is equals to your equation, okay. So from this you can see where is your x. So before that you are having the value 1 by 2, that would be your b, and this is your a, clear. That is a is equals to 5 and b is equals to your 1 by 2. So from this only you can just find out your b. Then you are having one data, that is sy is to sx is equals to what it is, 5 is to 8. So you can write it like this, sy upon sx is equals to 5 by 8. Clear? So like this you are having the formula. Now you are knowing how to find out the b formula, that is b is equals to r into sy upon sx, because we are having this data with you, so that is why we are using this formula. Clear with this? So we will be moving with this formula. Now you have to write the formula like this. So you are having your b as 1 by 2, or you can write 0.5 also. Then you are not having the value of r, then sy is 5 by 8, sy upon sx, clear. So then you can take your calculators. So 5 by 8 is 5 divided by 8, right? So 0.625. if you want to take your 1 by 2 as 0.5, then also it is there is no problem, then just divide it. So 0.5 divided by 0.625. so your r is, should I write like this, it should be, is equals to r, therefore your r is equals to 0.8. now you have to find out your coefficient of determination. Clear? So the formula is capital R square is equals to square of the small r. So your r is 0.8. The whole square would be 0.64. Clear? So this is your coefficient of determination. Clear with this? Now there is another question, that is subsection of illustration number 2. What it is? This was number 1. Clear? Now we are moving with number 2. That is, it is saying that, just concentrate on the question. If the regression line of y on x is 4x plus 5 minus 65 is equals to 0, find the value of the regression coefficient, that is your b. So let's do that now. So read the question. It is said y on x is 4x plus 5y, 4x plus 5y minus 65 is equals to 0. Then you have to find out your b. So you have to find out b from this equation itself. Now first of all, you have to look at this equation. Now you have to convert in the general form. So for that, see, for it would be like this: 5y is equals to 65, moving that side negative, it would be become positive, and this is positive, so it would become negative. Then y is equals to 65 minus 4x divide by 5. Clear? So from this you can get the y. Now you can see, we can make it one step more simpler by just dividing it. Okay, so divide it separately like this. So we are having 5, 13s are 65, right? So 13 minus 4x divide by 5, like this. Now you can take this in your decimal for the better calculation. So it would be like this: 4 divided by 5 would be like 0.8. So 13 minus 0.8x, like this. Clear? I got the answer: 13 minus 0.8x. Now you can see this is your y. Clear? So from this we have to take the y cap. So y cap is a plus bx, right? So from this you have to take your b only. So you can see your a would be 13 and b would be minus 0.8. so you are with your answer right now. We only had to find out the value of b. So from this we are having our b value. Clear with this? Now look at your illustration number 21. The first question, it is saying if your byx is equals to 0.85, byx is equals to 0.85 given to you, and your x is equals to, what it is? Sorry, your u is equals to x minus 15. So this would be like this, okay? X minus a, that is your assumed value, and v is equals to, it has been given, y minus 20, that is y minus b. Okay, do remember this. Now what they are asking, find the value of b, v, u. Clear? So you are knowing a is your 15, b is equals to 20, but you are also knowing that your b y x is only equal to b u v. So therefore your answer would be the same as b y x. So the answer for your b u v u is equals to 0.85. clear with this? Now let's do the second sum. Now read the second question. It is saying your u is equals to, given as x minus 5/3, that is x minus a divided by cx given to you, and your v is equals to y minus 8 divided by 5, that is y minus b divided by cy. This much data is given to you. So you can see your cx would be 3, a is equals to 5, and your cy is equals to 5 and b is equals to 8. Clear? Then they are asking, find the value of b v u. So you have to find the value of b v u. Clear? So you are knowing that the formula is like this. BYX is equals to your BVU, which is, now if you are having the value of CY and CX, so what is the formula when these values are given to you? So it would be like this, BVU is equals to BYX into CX upon CY. Clear with this? Now you are having the value of BYX, that is, yes, it is 0.9, sorry, not 9, it is 0.9 multiplied by your CX was, how much it was? Yes, it is 3 by 5, like this. So 3 by 5 is 0.6 multiplied by 0.9, it would be, answer is 0.54, that is your BVU is equals to 0.54. Clear with this, with your second sum. Now the question number 3 and 4 is similar to each other, so nothing, you have to do this in your homework. I am not explaining, but I would give you a hint. Again, in this sum, in these both sums, first of all you have to find out your A and B, and you have to find out your CX and CY. Okay, so and your BYX is given to you as 0.25. So after finding out this, you would be getting your answer of BUV. Clear? Again, in illustration number 21, subsection number, question number 4, again you have to find out, this is not important, that important, but this CX and CY is important to you. And again, your BYX is given to you as 0.25. BYX is equals to 1.6. Clear? So 1.6 it is given to you. So from then again, that formula, what it is, the formula, BVU is equals to BYX into what it is, CX upon CY. So BYX is given to you 1.6, and you have to find out this and this. After that you would be getting your BVU answer. Clear with this? So these two homework, these are the two homework that you have to do it in your rough book or notebook, wherever you want. Just practice all the sums, and I hope today's session is clear to you. If you are having any doubts, please ask me in our WhatsApp group. Clear? So thank you for the today's session.